Winter is coming. We know what's coming with it. We can't face it alone.
Hello, and welcome to the Super Wheeler Bros Podcast. I'm Jake Wheeler.
Are you now? And I'm Mike Wheeler.
Why do you have to say it like that? Are you now?
Are you now? So, yeah. It's been a couple weeks. Last week we had some scheduling conflict, and we did not get to do a podcast last week. So, yeah, there's a lot of motherfucking shit that has gone down, be it really? NBA playoffs, be it E3, which we're probably going to save until next week. So,
yeah, considering I don't really know anything about it, what E3?
It's gaming. We did it last year. The gaming convention is going on right now where all these badass, you know.
There's only one game coming out that matters, so it doesn't matter.
And it comes out next week.
Yeah, I know.
I will definitely be playing it all day. I'll probably live stream some of it. Just if
I was gonna request off, but I didn't do it enough time, so.
Oh, bummer.
Yeah, whatever. I'm taking off either the week after that or the week after that anyway.
Yeah.
For Indiana Beach.
Right.
And if Caitlin is working by then, doesn't have vacation days by then, I'll have a day where I'm just sitting around here anyway. So I'm kind of hoping that happens.
Nice.
But that is a couple weeks away. I might even have it done by then.
Yeah.
I don't know. Whatever.
It's going to be sweet. Can't wait for it. It's going to be awesome. But there's some major shit that's been announced. Like I said, we're probably going to save that for next week because we have a full-scale mutiny. A Game of Thrones.
Damn it, Coltrane.
That I'm going to have. Yeah. It was Coltrane's fault. So.
Right. We can definitely talk about Game of Thrones.
We will. It's one thing real quick. I got to say, I know that there's this theory that birds, like, can't hold their shit in, and they just shit wherever. I think that's a lot of bullshit. Because every time I get my car cleaned, or every time I clean my car...
Oh, okay. I was like, what are you talking about?
There's no, like, no hesitation. Like, it rained today. As soon as it got done raining, shit everywhere. And yeah. And I checked all the cars along the street, along the telephone lines. It's just my car.
How do they know birds can't hold their shit in?
I don't know. I've just been told this with Jake Carr, buddy at work, mentioned the other day that because I was like complaining about it because I had to go to Mike's car wash because there was like the biggest pile of bird shit. It was like berry bird
shit. So if they're in their nest and they have to shit, they just shit?
Apparently.
I don't think so.
Yeah. I think they just...
I've never seen a bird's nest with shit in it. And I'm not saying I've seen a million birds' nests, but I mean, I've seen some.
You're gonna say, what are you, a fucking woodsman?
No, but I mean, like, they fall out of the trees and stuff. Like, I've worked landscaping and shit. I've seen probably a good 10 to 15 birds' nests in my day.
And there was no shit in that bird's
I've
nest.
I've never noticed any, like, oh, there's bird shit in there. Was he shitting on his kids or shitting on their eggs?
Well,
like,
they do vomit into their children's mouths.
Well, yeah, but that's for, like, think they shit in their mouths, too.
I mean, I wouldn't put it past them. They're dirty fuckers.
I guess. I mean, I don't know. I could be wrong. I just feel like that's... Yeah, no. Nah.
Anyway, I was very pissed off.
Okay.
Because I'm so tired of my car being shit on.
Okay.
And then nobody else's car is getting shit on.
Trust me, everybody's car is getting shit on.
I don't know, man. I was looking up and down, and nobody's car was fucking pelted.
My car gets shit on.
Yeah, well, I mean, that it might be just one car a street. I don't know.
That's why I want to park my car in the garage again so it stops getting bird shit on it. And I stop getting into it, and it's fucking, like, roasting when I leave from here.
Oh, my
anyway.
God. It's awful.
It's one thing I hate about the summer.
And I got leather seats, too.
Oh,
so
that's even worse. Yeah. Is it black interior, too?
No, it's tan, so that's good. Okay. Could be worse.
I have cloth seats, and it's not a black interior, so it's not that bad. But it still gets fucking hot in there.
It gets fucking hot,
man. I leave sunglasses in my car, too, and I go to put them on, and they're just like...
Yeah, especially when they got metal frames.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I have to wear them because I can't see shit in the sun.
Yep. Me neither.
Yeah.
So, like I said, we're going to probably try to get into NBA Finals, Game of Thrones, a couple different things that were for movies. I mean, Christopher Lee passing away, things like that.
We can talk about why I'm wearing a sleeveless shirt.
We can talk about that right now. Let's get that out of the way. Let's get the fucking elephant in the room out of the way.
Yeah. Why is he wearing a tank top?
Why is his chest hair popping out the top of his shirt?
Oh, it is.
Yeah, baby.
I'm a hairy motherfucker. Yeah, no, I'm just wearing this because I got a tattoo.
You got it finished, right? Is it done? It's done, right?
Well, no, because they're going to do the inside part, too.
Oh, okay. Just wrapping all the way around?
Oh, yeah, man. Full half sleeve. A half sleeve.
A full half sleeve Batman.
Yeah, it's fucking Batman. Like, I don't know if you can see this. I mean, I don't know how nerdy this is.
Well, you're putting it right over the microphone, so how about you come right in the middle?
But if right in the middle, the...
You know what? It doesn't fucking matter then.
So I'm saying, I think they can see this. It's next to the microphone. Plus, you're not going to be able to see it anyway, like in a lot of detail. But yeah, I had part of it done. I just got the rest of at least the front part done.
You'll have to walk up to the camera at the end of the show.
Okay. The only thing that he has left to do on this part is he wants to touch it up the next time I go. He's just going to like touch up some of it. And then he's going to put some actual, the only color that's really going to be on it, he's going to put white in some of the windows in the background and make it look like they're like glowing, like the lights are on, and in Batman's eyes.
Oh, that'll be cool.
Cause fuck none of that eyeball shit like in the movies. No, he has white slits for eyes. Even though that makes no sense, but it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter, dude. It's gonna be sweet. I like it. It looks good. It looks better than when you first got it done. I was like, I mean, it looked good, but I was just kind of like,
now it's like a whole scene.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, the inside is just going to be mostly Gotham. I was thinking about asking him if he could put, like, a gargoyle or two on the back part. Because Batman...
I know, but what do you... That's going to fucking hurt.
Gotham. I don't want, like, a huge gargoyle. I mean, there's, like, a little gargoyle sitting there.
On the inside of your arm? So, like, when you're putting deodorant on, be like, what up, gargoyle?
What's up, man? You and Batman talk lately? Although, I guess it was Spider-Man that actually talked to him.
Talk to the gargoyles?
Yeah.
I don't think Batman talks to gargoyles.
No. But there's like, I feel like, I don't know, maybe.
He just, all he says is, I am vengeance. I am the night.
I am the night.
I am Batman.
The night is dark and full of terrors. Mm-hmm. It always makes me think of Batman when they say that.
Yep.
But yeah, it is. Batman's going to kick those terrors' ass.
So.
Anyway. Yeah, tattoo. That's why I put Batman up there. That's the only reason.
Is that like that's 60s Batman?
Yeah, this is not 60s Batman. This is
it's like Dark Knight Returns, right?
This is.
No. He's got pretty short.
No, this is modeled off of Jim Lee's Batman.
Okay.
Jim Lee, I think, is probably my favorite Batman
artist.
Who he's now like running Marvel, so I'm not Marvel.
Or DC. Yikes. You nerd.
I'm drunk already. Yeah, he's already been, he's been pretty much running DC now. Well, not really, but
yeah.
He's up there. Anyway.
Yeah. So, yeah.
It hurts.
Speaking of Marvel, though, there's a pretty major story, or two major ones this week, revolving around Daredevil that I thought were very interesting. One is that Jason Statham was rumored to be playing Bullseye in season 2 of Daredevil.
Yeah, and the rumor is also that he backed out of that because it was leaked on the internet.
Well, that would make Jason Statham a punk-ass
bitch. Yeah, that's just a stupid internet rumor I heard, I think, though.
I mean, maybe he's going to do it, maybe he's not. My question is, what do you think about that potential casting? Do you like it?
Jason Statham as Bullseye?
Yeah.
It's fine, I guess.
Are you indifferent?
I mean...
Bullseye doesn't require, like, huge acting chops. You're not going to get like some weird over the top, like completely ridiculous portrayal like Colin Farrell. You could tell that he just knew like this movie is going to be kind of bad, like not like it. I love that movie.
I think he was falling into the trap of that it's like a comic book villain. I have to be over the top, like, because that's the way comic book villains used to be played. Right. They used to be just straight up, doesn't matter who it is, it's over the top.
Mm-hmm.
It's over the top as fuck.
Right.
That's the way they were played. And you have to remember back at that time.
That was before Ian McKellen dig Magneto and was like, no, this is how you do it.
Yeah, was Daredevil before X-Men, though?
No.
Okay.
Oh, you're right. So it's not Daredevil like... came out like right after X-Men.
Well, X-Men was like one of the... X-Men and Spider-Man, but even Spider-Man, they're all over the top. I mean, really.
I think Spidey kind of came out after Daredevil.
It came out... X-Men was... Blade was like the first, like...
And Deacon Frost is definitely over the top.
He's over the top, but not like that.
I thought
shit.
Steven Dorff was pretty cool.
Yeah, no, I like... No, the Blade movies are exceptions, and then X-Men and Spider-Man, I think, were the first ones, and then, like, they were good, but then everything
Spidey
else...
Spidey had over-the-top villains in that series.
No, they did have over-the-top villains. They've always had over-the-top villains in all of them.
Amazing Spider-Man. Well, the Lizard wasn't that bad.
Yeah, I guess he wasn't that bad,
but Electro and Green Goblin, way too over-the-top.
You know what? Green Goblin's supposed to be over-the-top, but...
Yeah. I liked Willem Dafoe's Green Goblin, other than the hideous suit he was wearing.
Yeah. Yeah, anyway, we're not really getting
into we're getting off to a
tangent.
I'm
just saying. Anyway. Shit, what was I saying? but no, they've all been kind of over the top. But, like, you know, X-Men had good villains, because fucking you get Ian McKellen as your villain, it's going to be good.
Yeah, yeah.
And Spider-Man, they had good villains, but they were over the top. And I think the fact that those were over the top and Spider-Man, X-Men was a hit the first one when it came out.
Yes.
But Spider-Man was huge.
Spider-Man was huge. So, $400 million. Hadn't been a $400 million movie in a while.
So I think everybody kind of started to see that. And then let's see what came out. Fantastic Four came out.
Yeah, over the top.
He was over the top and
awful.
Dr. Doom.
They ruined, like... Didn't they stop making Fantastic Four comics?
Yeah, now they have. Marvel's pretty much like, fuck that. Because they're making that new one.
And Fantastic Four was like their biggest property when they first came out.
It was like their... It was their tentpole. It was like their first one, really. Yeah,
it was their tentpole. Which is bad, because I think Fantastic Four...
They rebranded it and turned it into the Fantastic Four later, but I'm pretty sure like one of their earliest stories was like...
Yeah, that story.
That story.
Yeah, that's a shame. That movie, by the way, looks like a pile of shit.
Eventually, it'll probably come back. Yeah, I'm hoping it just fails, like, honestly.
Like Spider-Man did, even though Spider-Man was cool.
I didn't hate Spider-Man. Like, there was some shit I hated about The Amazing Spider-Man 2. Electro was just awful.
Yeah.
He was just fucking awful.
Green Goblin was also
awful.
It's
so bad. But I still stand by the fact that Andrew Garfield was a way better Spider-Man. Yeah. And him and Emma Stone together just made those fucking movies.
Yeah, well, it makes it easy to watch when you can root for characters. So.
And her, spoilers, death, if you don't know that, her death at the end of the second one was still, like, really sad to me.
Mm-hmm.
Even though the first time I saw it, that it was ruined for me. Or the second first time, yeah,
that pissed me off.
Yeah, that did. But we don't need to get into that. We've talked about that before.
White bitch.
Yeah, you white bitch. Hey, you know, sometimes she.
You know, I haven't gone to see a midnight showing since then.
I didn't say that.
What'd you say?
I said sometimes she is. It's all right. Everybody is. Have I gone and seen a midnight showing since then? I don't think I have either.
Not one.
That was a midnight showing?
That was a midnight showing.
Are you serious? Yeah. We went to a midnight showing of that?
Spider-Man.
When those kids were in there like that? That's why I didn't think they were fucking kids.
It was 10 o'clock, technically. It's not a midnight showing, but it was
Thursday night, right?
It was the preview night.
Yeah, that's fucking stupid. Yeah. Anyway, where the hell... How do we get on this tangent? Over the
We're
top
talking
villains.
About Daredevil.
Over the top villains. Oh yeah, Colin Farrell.
Colin Farrell.
Yeah. oh yeah. What else was coming out around then? Is what I was trying to say. Like, what else came out? Like, Fantastic Four was over the top. I mean, Daredevil came out and he played it over the top.
Blade 2 came out.
Blade 2 didn't play that over the top.
No,
because really.
Luke Gost was the man.
And you know what? Blade 3.
That was
wasn't
way over
played
the top.
Over the top enough.
Yeah. Probably not.
No, because he's all Blade, ready to die. Like,
motherfucker, I like that.
Motherfucker, I like that. Yeah, no, he needed to bring it up a little bit.
No, Blade was playing it over the top like, I was born ready, motherfucker.
Nah, man, that was the best fucking part of the movie.
What, the fight?
Yeah, and him, the beginning of that, ready to die. Born ready, motherfucker.
Man, Blade was the shit, man.
Dude, I have a hard time believing they'll be as good of a Blade as him.
Problem is, Wesley Snipes played it perfectly.
Oh yeah,
And Wesley Snipes is a badass motherfucker.
And people will start to, and everyone's just gonna want to be Wesley Snipes when they do it. Like when they made that TV series, the guy was just awful. Trying to be Wesley Snipes.
But like, he was a big, kind of like fat, bald-headed motherfucker.
Yeah. So I don't know. Anyway, I'm not even talking about the Blade movies because the Blade movies didn't have. Like, I thought those worked. And even Spider-Man was over the top, and it worked. And I
don't Fantastic think Blade Four was definitely over the top. Fantastic Four,
Bullseye, and even though, what's his name, Michael Clark Duncan didn't play it too over the top.
I mean... No, not really.
He was kind of subdued, but...
Not really. But everything about that movie was over the top, though.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah. Yeah, sleeping in a fucking water coffin every night. Like, what the fuck is that?
What about the fucking fight on the playground with Electra?
I mean,
that was so that was fucking bad. Dumb.
Yeah. The cops would have been called immediately. Oh, God. There's people fighting on a playground. There's kids around.
They're like, fight.
Yeah, that was really
bad. He fought her to get her number.
He did.
And he didn't get it.
She never looked that good again.
No.
She never looked that good before that.
Not really, no.
She just came out of nowhere in that movie.
Nope.
Is that the only movies, though, really? I mean, Ghost Rider was definitely...
Way over the top.
Everything about that movie was over the top, though. Yeah. You're right. Same thing with that. So, just anyway, it was in that era, is basically what I was trying to say. So. Yeah,
definitely. Well, all those, like, second-tier Marvel movies, Punisher was kind of over the top.
I mean, in the old, like,
you know,
Batman movies were over the top.
Yeah. I mean, X-Men...
Superman was kind of over the top. What, like
Returns?
No, not Returns. Well, I mean... Lex Luthor has always been a little over the top. But I mean, like, no, I mean, like, the old Superman movies, too. Superman.
Oh, okay, I got
Superman
you.
2.
Sure.
You know?
Sure. First of all, Terrence Stamp is a beast.
Nah, he was fucking awesome. I love that movie, but.
Kneel before Zod. I love the end, though. The end of that movie is still the best thing ever.
Yeah, you want to talk about over the top?
Don't even get me started on Richard Lester. He fucked that movie six ways from Sunday. That cellophane S.
The more I think about it, the cellophane S was the worst thing ever. I mean, him kissing Lois and making her fucking lose her memory, that's pretty... that's the worst thing ever.
Yeah.
But no, but I mean, they're both, they're equally dumb.
That's so bad.
This, like, where'd that come from?
And it just keeps growing.
Yeah.
It's huge.
What the hell is that? Who has cellophane S power? I mean,
what the fuck? I mean, seriously, though.
Come here, Lois. What happened, me. Clark? I don't know. Lois. I don't know.
And then she's pregnant. Well, Lois, I gave you the D, and then you didn't want to talk to me anymore. So, yeah. Anyway.
I love that argument about Superman Returns.
How did she know he was Superman's kid if he didn't remember fucking him?
Well, yeah, and like, I don't know who it was. It was a comedian or somebody talking about it. They're like, and then after she realizes that, isn't she like, what the fuck? Superman raped me. Like, what the hell? Why don't I remember that?
Why don't I remember this?
Superman speed raped me. I didn't even know it.
Oh, he could probably do it. Like, I remember there was a long time ago, there was a video of Superman flying across Metropolis. And just fucking all the girls that were sunbathing on top of buildings, and they never even knew it.
Yeah, there's that joke about, wasn't the Invisible Girl, Wonder Woman and the Invisible Man.
Yeah.
Superman, it's in Hollow Man.
Right.
That's what it's in. Superman's just flying across the city, sees Wonder Woman just laying there naked, just like, completely just sprawled out and everything. So he's just like, you know what? Faster than a fucking speeding bullet? Fuck it, I'm just gonna go in and I'll be out of there.
Fuck Wonder Woman.
Yeah. So he goes down there, ba-ba-bam, does his thing, flies away, cut back to Wonder Woman. What the hell was that? Invisible Man says, I don't know, my ass is killing me.
I love that joke.
Yeah, it's fucking hilarious.
Oh, it's great.
And especially being told in Hollow Man.
Yes, Hollow Man. That's an overtop movie if I haven't ever seen one. Jesus.
But I kind of like it.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty good. Elizabeth Shue's in it, and she was a hottie for a long
Kevin
time.
Kevin Bacon is in it, man. That's all you need.
At least he didn't show his bacon in that one.
No, he didn't. What the fuck was I talking about before that? Yeah, he could, you know, he could fucking rape Lois. I don't know who it was, who's talking about that, but it really is just like, after she realizes that, she shouldn't be, like, happy about it. She should be, like, visit him in the hospital, like, what the fuck, you raped me, you asshole. Yeah. Explain this.
Explain my 5-year-old that killed somebody with a piano. Mm.
Yeah.
I'm sorry I left you, Lois. I'll take you back now.
Sorry I raped you, Lois. And then, anyway. he has to try to be like, no, look, see, we did have sex. And then I kissed you, and you forgot. Yeah, you erased your memory. And then she's like,
I didn't know that was one of your powers, motherfucker. Nah. Yeah, I developed it for one movie, sorry.
Yeah. I kind of developed it because it was conveniently...
Right.
Kind of convenient in that stupid plot.
Fuck you, Richard Lester.
I digress.
That's why I like the... If I wish the Richard Donner cut would have, like, finished special effects, because then it would be better. But there's a lot of things to like about the Richard Lester version, just not that shit.
Anyway. Yeah. I don't even know how the fuck we start talking about that. Oh, Daredevil announcements.
Yes.
You didn't even get to the second
one. The other one is Jon Bernthal has been officially cast as the Punisher. And then I saw the picture of him, like, really pumped up about it. So I'm on board.
No, I think he'll be fine. I mean, if there's any second guessing I have about it, and there really isn't. It's just that everything I've seen him in, he has been more over the top. And I don't think the Punisher needs to be over the top.
Really. No, because we had an over the top Punisher.
Not really.
Warzone, way over the top.
No, he wasn't over the top in that, though.
No,
I'm talking about I haven't seen Jon Bernthal play a character who's not like fucking...
I don't know, dude.
I don't know, Rick.
Yeah, but he played a lot of smaller stuff in
Walking Dead. I haven't seen him in a lot of smaller stuff. I've only seen him in like that, Wolf of Wall Street, and I mean, I guess I watched a little bit of that miniseries he was in. He was all right in that.
Yeah, that one that should have gone on longer that I thought was really cool.
I think he can do it. I'm just saying that if I had any, you know, any kind of...
He can definitely do the badass stuff.
If I had any trepidation about it, would be because I've only seen him more over the top out there characters. But no, I think he can. I think he's a good actor. I think he'll be good. Plus, he's from like New York, isn't
he's
he?
From,
so,
yeah, he's from.
So yeah, it'll just be natural for him to talk like that too.
I don't know what borough he's from, but yeah,
you know, instead of.
I mean, how many times do you think he's going to touch his hair over or under 5 times?
If you really watch The Walking Dead, he really is just like all of his facial expressions, just like he just does like, really big eyes and just.
Scratching his head and shit. You're right, man. That is enough.
Pretty much. But no, I think he'll be good at it. I mean, and it's going to be interesting to see how much he's in it and how he interacts with Daredevil because they have two different philosophies on how to deal with shit.
I do miss Shane in Walking Dead, though.
Well, we'll get him in something even better now because Daredevil was better than Walking Dead. That's right.
Definitely was. For one season.
Well, yeah. Oh, I mean, come on.
Walking Dead's a staple, though, on TV.
Oh, no, so. I'm not knocking Walking Dead at all.
Definitely good. And Andrew Lincoln is just awesome.
Yeah.
So
I'd like to see him find a good role in a Marvel or DC movie. I don't know what that role would be, though.
Nope.
I'm sure there's probably something. And I'm not saying it even has to be like a big hero or
villain. I don't know. He could have played like a Star-Lord type, I thought, but...
Probably. He could probably play like...
I ain't even worried about
it. I was going to say like a Green Lantern, but... He probably could, but...
Yeah.
It's not interesting enough. He needs an interesting role.
Definitely.
He needs to be doing things.
He needs to be doing things. Yeah. Anyway, so Jon Bernthal, I love that he was pumped about it. So speaking of which, there's a couple of things in here... that kind of was freaking me out a little bit because Marvel and Sony are having a hard time agreeing on who should play Spidey.
Yeah.
And I was really warming up to Asa Butterfield. And now we've got dudes that I have no idea who it is. So.
I have no idea who any of these people are. I hardly even know who that motherfucker is. I know he's been in a couple movies that
I haven't
seen.
Yeah, like Hugo and stuff like that.
Yeah, I never saw Hugo.
But so. I will make one opinion abundantly clear.
I think he'll be fine.
Whatever... Marvel wants to do Sony, fucking do it.
Yeah, but they have a contract together already, so it'll be fine. I think. I don't think they're. Plus, Marvel is like planning on putting them in a movie that they're shooting right now. So
yeah, so they need to get it done.
So they're probably going to be like, okay, come on,
yeah,
let's do this thing.
Let's fucking go.
Yeah, so. Come on. They like someone at Marvel just needs to be like Sony.
Come on,
Come on. We're about to put him in Captain America Civil War. You don't think they're going to want to see the continuation of that in your movie? Fuck you. Come on.
Yeah, let's go.
Go fuck yourself.
Captain America Civil War is going to make $500 million. Okay. Yeah. So, switching over to DC side. Can't wait
to see that motherfucker as Aquaman.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. Switching over to DC side, there is a kind of a rumor going around on what Ezra Miller and Jason Momoa's cameos in Batman v Superman will be. And it does look like they are small cameos, nothing big. There's a scene where Batman breaks deep into LexCorp or Cadmus and manages to hack into LexCorp computers. Batman brings up surveillance footage on the monitors, which shows Ezra Miller's Flash is a blur that stops a robbery. And Jason Momoa's Aquaman is held prisoner in a containment chamber where we see his hand slap against the glass. So,
very subtle.
Very cool with that. Definitely. Don't What's need to go crazy. The
interesting about that is Aquaman being in captivity.
Mm-hmm. And Lex is the one that captured him.
Yeah, so that just makes you think maybe Justice League will be about fighting that motherfucker.
Mm-hmm.
You know, break out and rain Fuck the seas you. Down on us. Yeah.
Well, and think about this, though. Like, that does kind of set up Lex Luthor being formidable. Being able to capture Aquaman.
I guess that's true.
So, I think the more and more I think about it, Jesse Eisenberg's going to have a really different Lex Luthor.
Well, I mean, I don't have any doubt that he can play a good role.
It's going to be more of a thinking man, though.
We'll just see how... Yeah, it's not going to be as physical, which I've gotten past that.
Well, none of the Lexes that they've cast has been physical in the least, so... Gene Hackman, that's Kevin true. Spacey, and...
Now You're Jesse right about Hackman. That. I think that's kind of why I wanted to see one, finally.
Yeah. See, like, I thought Michael Rosenbaum was physical enough.
Yeah, to go up against that Superman. To go up against Teenage Superman, yeah. Lex Luthor is, like... And I know he can't actually just go up against Superman. No one can. But, I mean, like, he at least looks like he could, if you don't know that Superman.
Yeah.
Sam next to Clark Kent, you think he'd kick his ass.
Right.
Like...
There you go.
Yeah.
All right, before I get to... kind of the big stuff to do with the movie that absolutely crushed the box office this weekend that I'm going to see later. I'm going to talk about Christopher Lee passing away. And Dusty Rhodes, for that matter. The American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, WWE superstar.
I know who Dusty Rhodes is.
So, that was sad, definitely, but my heart was a little more heavy for Christopher Lee.
Mine was definitely more heavy for Christopher Lee. I know who Dusty Rhodes is. I'm never a fan. I mean, that's, you know.
More of a fan of his offspring, really.
Yeah.
Gold Dust and Cody Rhodes and shit.
Yeah, I wasn't really fans of them either.
Not really. I mean, so, they weren't the best.
No, I mean, but they were.
Dusty Rhodes was definitely the best.
Yeah, he was.
In the family, yeah, for sure. He was one of the Four Horsemen, I believe.
And they were all part, very big parts of wrestling when I watched them. So, I mean, Gold Dust was in
the Attitude Era.
Yeah, so. And then when I was watching it really, really young, Dusty Rhodes was there. So, no, they were both really, I mean, he was a really big part of me watching that when I was younger. And, you know.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, it's sad, but I just, you know, I don't have like a personal connection with it, I guess.
Right.
I mean, I don't even really with Christopher Lee either. I mean, I got Lord of the Rings.
That was definitely, for me, because obviously we're a younger generation than the previous generation who pretty much recognizes him as Dracula.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that was the big thing.
Yeah, and he was a good Dracula, too, because I've seen...
Eight different movies?
Yeah, I've seen a couple of them, so...
But, yeah, he was a Count great Dooku. Bond villain.
And he was Count Dooku.
And he was Count Dooku. He was
the first motherfucker to fight Yoda on film.
Yep. Well, sort of. He was definitely CGI'd just as much as Yoda was.
Obviously Yoda CGI, but
yes, but so was Count Dooku.
Yeah, but his face was on there. I mean, it doesn't matter. He's not actually fighting him anyways. Who gives a
All
shit?
I know is when I saw Yoda pull out the lightsaber and go at him.
When you watch the movie, who's he fighting?
That's
my point.
But seriously though, when we were in the theater and Yoda comes walking in after Obi-Wan and Anakin have been defeated, and Yoda comes in just limping with his cane and throws it on the ground and pulls out his fucking lightsaber. Oh, man. That was so awesome.
Oh, I know. I was literally, like, bouncing in my seat when, like, he pulled out his lightsaber. I was like... Like, I'm sorry. As much as anybody hates the prequels, totally worth it for that.
Well, and the Phantom Menace fight with
I know Darth Maul. The lightsaber fights in these movies were really good. Even the one with in the beginning of the third one with
Anakin
Obi-Wan and Anakin and Qui-Gon Dooku.
Yeah, the best one by far besides the Darth Maul one, it probably was Anakin versus Obi-Wan in
Revenge. Yeah, that was
badass in the lava planet.
Man,
we've talked about this many times. Yeah. We don't have to go over it again. Fucking
third movie's good.
They're all good. The third movie's great.
Yeah, third movie's up there with the better ones.
You know, people just got to get over their bullshit. That's the same way The Hobbit was mistreated, that trilogy, and it was awesome.
Hobbit was not as good as Lord of the Rings. No. And I don't think the original trilogy is... I mean, I don't think the newer trilogy is better than the original trilogy.
No.
But I just think that it's hated on way too much.
Yep.
Like, they're still pretty fucking good movies. Yeah, definitely. There's some shit in 1 and 2 especially that I don't like, but...
Yeah. Clearly.
The Hobbit, though, man. Like, the Hobbit was awesome. Those fucking movies are awesome.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
One man's opinion.
Speaking of which, Peter Jackson wrote an excerpt. It's pretty long. I don't know if I want to read it.
Yeah, we don't need to read
that. But he wrote an excerpt basically saying that Christopher Lee was an incredible dude. He spoke 7 languages, and he was a man of the world. I mean, he was in the SAS.
Oh, that's another reason. That's another reason that I feel more sad for Christopher Lee too, because he was fucking awesome. Like, he was into like everything, and he was like, I don't know. He made metal albums.
Yes, he did
metal Christmas albums.
He was a heavy metal guitarist. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, he loved working with Tim Burton.
Obviously,
he was Hammer horror years that he was in with Dracula, you know. Peter Jackson mentions that I remember him saying on my 40th birthday, he was 80 at the time, you're half the man I am. Being half the man Christopher Lee is something he said that he would hope he could be.
More than he could ever hope for.
Right. So, you know, I mean, he was a great Bond villain in a terrible Bond movie. The Man with the Golden Gun. So, but he basically goes on to say that this will be a lesser place without him.
Yep.
So, and I was I was playing Lego The Hobbit. I've been playing that this past week a lot, and he actually voices a lot of the like the segues, like telling the story. It's all Christopher Lee doing it. So, and I just thought it was so cool that I know he wanted to play Gandalf, but he accepted any role that he could to be a part of these books that he loved. So, with Tolkien.
Yeah.
But, there you go. Dear Christopher, practically perfect in every way. Love Peter, Fran, and Philippa? I don't know. Peter and Fran? I don't know. I can't read anything lower there.
Yeah, it says Peter
and Fran. Peter and Fran? Okay. Which Peter Jackson and Fran Walsh are married. So.
Yes.
But anyway, we'll miss you, Saruman, Dracula, whatever you want to call him. So,
Count Dooku,
yeah, definitely some iconic roles from when I was growing up for sure.
Darth Tyrannus.
Yes, he was Darth Tyrannus. Yeah,
Tyrannus. Mm-hmm. Right.
Right.
Yeah.
Speaking of Tyrannus, good segue. Jurassic World, pretty much obliterated any and all records. It even surpassed the opening weekend record of The Avengers.
Really?
Yes. Yes, it did. And
all right.
And it's the first movie ever to cross $500 million globally in one weekend.
Wow.
Yeah. But here's what I thought was really cool. Marvel, very, very, very gracious. They basically sent this picture out on a tweet. Marvel Studios congratulates Jurassic World on being the new opening weekend king, and it's got fucking Chris Pratt on top of Tyrannosaurus Rex with all the Avengers pointing like, what the fuck?
And the Tyrannosaurus is holding Mjolnir.
Oh, the Tyrannosaurus is holding Mjolnir, yeah. But Kevin Feige sent out, congrats Mr. Spielberg, Universal Picks, Legendary, the Doctor, Kevin Trevorrow, and especially Pratt. Christopher Pratt right there.
Pratt.
Chris Pratt is pretty much a bona fide motherfucking movie star at this point.
Yeah, he is.
And like I said, if he gets cast as Indy, There might not be a bigger dude on the planet right now.
I'll be like, bang, bang.
Yeah. I'm really happy for Chris Pratt because he just seems like such a down-to-earth dude, and he's hilarious. Mm-hmm. So I just like Chris Pratt a lot. But Jurassic World, $208 million the first weekend. That's insane. Yeah. But
208. Yeah, I mean, I still want to see it. I'm not, like, super excited to see it because I don't think any of those movies will ever touch the first one.
Right. First one is, like, one of the Holy Grail kind of movies for me.
Yeah, so. But, I mean, yeah, I definitely want to see it. I'm sure it's probably really cool.
Well, you know what sold me on going to see it was that Chris Pratt was in the movie, though. So, mm-hmm. You know, I thought it could have been really stupid. But, obviously, Lost World, I still think that holds a special place for me, too. And then, you know, Jurassic Park 3 wasn't awful.
No, none of them are, like, horrible. I mean, the second one is good. Not as good as the first, but good.
Right.
Third one's not quite as good as 2 to me. But they're all decent. I mean,
definitely.
I own all 3.
So do I. I just bought the trilogy that has a slot for Jurassic World.
Oh, yeah. You and Nick both did that. That white one?
Yeah.
Yeah. I was over at his apartment. We were just checking out his new place, and I saw that. I was like, what is this?
Yeah.
So I just bought that online. They have a slot for the fourth one. I was like, damn, dude. I don't want this. This thing's cool looking.
Yep.
But whatever. Alright.
It's all good. So, but Chris Pratt, he also confirmed that he's going to be back for some sequels.
Playing
Owen Grady.
He shouldn't, because nobody else will. I guess he should come back for one. Either the next one or the sixth one.
Right?
That's how...
Goldblum came back for was there for the first two, and then Sam Neill was there for 1 and 3.
1 and 3, so he should do 4 and 5, 4 and 6.
Yeah, I'm just happy for Spielberg because he finally got like a really big hit that he produced again.
You think so Jeff Goldblum will
make a cameo next time?
Cameo, or maybe even Sam Neill?
I don't know. I'm surprised that nobody made a cameo in this one. But then again, neither one of them probably would want a park to be open, so.
That's probably true.
I don't know what they're talking about down here.
Maybe next time we get that cameo.
What?
I said maybe next time we get that cameo.
I don't know what you're saying.
You don't know what I'm saying?
No.
Maybe next time we get that cameo.
Get the cameo?
Maybe next time we get that cameo.
Okay, I get it.
You notice that now?
Meh.
Can you translate that?
Maybe next time we'll get that cameo.
Maybe next time we get that cameo.
Yeah. All right. I didn't know you were channeling Brad Pitt from fucking Snatch.
I wasn't trying to do that.
I'm just saying.
It was trying to. I was being more Southern than Irish.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe next time we get that cameo.
We're getting a caravan.
That was more Spanish.
For me, man.
Maybe next time we get that cameo.
It's kind of hard to say those words and make it sound Irish. Yeah.
Maybe next time we get that cameo. Really, you can't do it. It's kind of hard.
It's just...
You can't do it.
You're just coming off sounding Indian now.
Maybe next time we get that cameo.
Maybe next time we'll get the cameo.
Maybe next time we get that cameo. I want to do it.
Maybe
next time we'll get the cameo.
Maybe next time we'll get the cameo.
You gotta go high pitch with it.
Maybe next time we'll get the cameo.
I'm done.
You're done.
I mean, I'm just trying to
liven it up.
Trying to get it done. Trying to
get her done.
Challenge me on that.
That's hard to do.
Next time we get the cameo. No, but maybe next time they will get the cameo.
Ow. Maybe next time my tailbone will cease to be pushed up my anus. Ow. I'm glad you made that face, though.
It's just not a pretty picture. Having your tailbone, which would have to be, like, pulled down and it curved in, then shoved up your asshole.
Right. Yeah.
So that just is not a...
Got it.
Yeah. It sucks to think about, isn't it? Because, I mean, you know, your tailbone is right there at the end of your... Like, not even to the end of your asshole anyway.
Right, I know.
For it to be shoved up your ass, it would have to be, like, pulled down... curved and then shoved back.
Right. No, I get it. I understand. That's why I said it. I was just saying that hurt.
All right. That does hurt.
Anyway.
It hurts a lot.
Speaking of something that really hurt, Jon Snow.
Are we already to that?
Yeah, let's go. Well, I mean, I tell you what, we'll save Game of Thrones for the end. Why don't we talk about fucking NBA Finals? Because I actually, you know what? Before we get to the NBA Finals,
okay.
I have something. By the way, LeBron, thanks for pulling out your dick. Appreciate that. Did you see that?
Yes, I did. Unfortunately, I saw his dick.
LeBron pulled out baby Bron.
Because I just had to be shown his dick.
Meatloaf. Long as I can get out of here to go see Jurassic World, yes. So probably I'll be fine.
What time you want to see Jurassic World?
8 o'clock.
Anyway, who are you going to see that with?
Tyler.
I don't know who that motherfucker is.
I work with Tyler.
Anyway, that's cool.
But yes.
Yes, LeBron's dick.
Saw LeBron's dick.
Didn't see LeBron's dick. And that's the only thing that's happened in the finals.
The Little King came out. But the prince. That's pretty funny. Anyway, so there's this video going around after the Game 5. Is it Game 5 loss? Yeah, because tonight's Game 6. The Game 5 loss where Golden State went up 3-2. Mm-hmm. And LeBron said, yes, I'm confident. Or no, I'm not feeling pressure. I'm confident because I'm the best player in the world.
Well, that's what they said. He's confident that they can still win. Like, why are you so confident? He's like... Or no, it wasn't even that. It was...
Do you feel the pressure to win or something?
Yeah, he was saying, like, it was something about the way he plays. It's like, how do you, you know... How do you go out there and play like that? And I've never... Something like that, the way he plays. And then he goes... Confident because I'm the best player in the world. I'm like, you know.
First, what do you want him to say? We have no chance?
I mean,
is that what you want him to say? We're gonna lose.
It's
basically his message to his team saying it ain't over yet.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think he has the right to say that because he is the best player in the world.
It's not even close. First of all, as good as Steph Curry was, and he was great in the last game, he closed that game out.
Yeah, but Steph Curry has been fucking wide
gaping hole between LeBron and, say, if it's Steph or Kevin Durant or Russell Westbrook or any of these other dudes. There is, like, LeBron and everybody else.
Well, that's what everybody's trying to say, too, and I'm not even trying to compare it to Michael Jordan, but even when you bring up that conversation, people are like, he's not scoring like Michael Jordan scored that much in the finals before. Like, yeah, but did Michael Jordan have, like, 15 or whatever, not even 15, but, like, 12 rebounds and 10 assists, too?
No, he did not average a fucking triple-double. It's never been done in the finals, just so you know.
Is he averaging a triple-double right now?
He is averaging 9 assists, 12 rebounds, and 37 points. That's ridiculous. LeBron is being so good.
Especially because he had a 20-something point game, right?
Yeah. LeBron is so good in these finals that he's literally being discussed as the second player only ever to maybe win a finals MVP without winning the finals.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, to his credit...
he said today that...
Yeah, doesn't mean shit.
Yeah.
I'm not here for an individual prize. I'm here for a team prize.
Yeah.
And that's the kind of stuff that pisses me off when people go on the attack. There's this video. Chris Jones. Hi, Chris Jones. He posted on Facebook basically saying, one, if you think LeBron is better than Michael Jordan, which, by the way, who the fuck makes that argument that's not 18 years old? Nobody thinks Michael is not better. He is better. He's the greatest. But if you're telling me there's not a discussion that LeBron couldn't maybe beat him one-on-one, or if there's not a discussion that LeBron isn't in his class,
that's ridiculous. Those are the people that make me laugh, are the people that say that he couldn't beat, that Jordan would beat him one-on-one now. Like, straight up.
Oh, those people are insane. Yeah. Insane. You're completely insane.
Even if Jordan can still, like, shoot well enough to score on him, I mean, he's not going to be able to stop him.
Well, first of all, that's insane. I even had Damon tell me that Jordan would beat Russell Westbrook one-on-one, and I laughed at him.
Dude, Russell Westbrook would kill him. Go right by him.
He would kill him.
Like, the guy's not super.
He's
human.
Like, he beat Kemba Walker. I said, is Kemba Walker?
It's fucking Kemba Walker.
Russell Westbrook?
No, not even close. It's not even like.
It's not even a comparison. But I'm just saying. I digress. So there's this video going around going class versus no class. And I'm being forced into this position, basically. And I love Michael Jordan. I think he's probably the greatest single athlete we've ever seen.
You don't think Michael Jordan thought he was the best player in the world?
He definitely did, and he said it many times, and I don't want to fucking hear it. They had this humble piece after he won an NBA Finals. Which, by the way, it's real fucking easy to be humble after you win the chip, just so you know. Mm-hmm. But they're asking LeBron to be defiant, and he has to be defiant to try and win. Do you think Michael would have been able to do this without Scottie Pippen or Dennis Rodman? No. It wouldn't have happened. Plus, his role players stepped up. J.R. Smith had 14 points in the first half and didn't make a shot the rest of the game.
Yeah, which is funny because when the game started, I was like, oh, here we go. Yeah, right. Here's that game.
And then he didn't have it. Yeah. And Iman Shumpert has been pretty much non-existent on offense. Matthew Dellavedova is out of gas at this point.
Yeah,
and
he's got he's okay on defense still, but he can't.
Tristan
do shit
Thompson
on
is still a liability offensively.
Yeah, he is.
So Kevin Love is the better player. Stop with that bullshit where you think Tristan Thompson's better than Kevin Love. He's not. He's not. And Kyrie Irving being out is a killer because everything has to go through LeBron. Mm-hmm. They're playing like hot potato. LeBron gives the ball to him, they throw it right back.
Yep. So it's like they're all scared to shoot it.
Yep.
The only one that's not scared to shoot it is J.R. Smith.
J.R. Smith is never scared. And I don't think Dellavedova is scared to shoot it either. He just has no legs anymore.
Yeah.
But, you know, Shumpert, you know, Mozgov played great. Why didn't he play more minutes?
Because they started doubling him right away. So they pulled him out.
Yeah, I guess. I mean, it's fine. It's fine. But my biggest issue with this class versus no class shit, and it really, really pisses me off, I'm about to take Michael Jordan to task, and I don't want to have to, but let's compare the two as human beings, since one person has class and one person does not have class, according to you people, since we're taking it off the basketball court. You want to say Michael Jordan's better than LeBron James on the basketball court? I'll give it to you all day long. I'm not even going to argue with you. Not even going to argue with you. But to try and say that a man who has not cheated on his wife. I'm sure if he would have cheated on his wife, it would come out by now. Okay? It came out while Michael Jordan was playing that he cheated multiple times. LeBron James does not have a gambling problem. Michael Jordan had a gambling problem. LeBron James is an ambassador for basketball, just the way Michael Jordan was, but in a much different way. Michael Jordan never, ever came out when there's an issue for black folks. You know, whenever there's something like Trayvon Martin or something like that, LeBron James is willing to take a stand, even if it might not be popular. That's a role model for anybody, really. But so Michael Jordan avoided every aspect when it came to that shit. He wanted no part of it. Nothing. So LeBron James, it's amazing. It's mind-boggling to me. He's taken care of his boys, his childhood friends, that he's never going to let, you know. And you know what's really great about LeBron James? He didn't just take care of them by just giving them money. He uplifted them, and now they're all successful men, all successful businessmen, you know. Rich Paul, now an agent, who Tristan Thompson and many other NBA guys that he's an agent for. I mean, come on. He is a person that you want to follow. Michael Jordan, greatest player ever. But don't give me this shit about him being classy, because Michael Jordan's really not that classy of a guy. Never gonna be, never pretended to be, other than on the court. See, that's why I like Kobe now more than I liked Kobe back then. Kobe back then was all about, oh, I'm the golden boy in the NBA. Now, Kobe just tells it like it is.
Kobe don't give a fuck anymore.
Right, and I love that. Just be who you are. LeBron's being who he is. He made one huge mistake.
That's why everyone hates him. I mean, it really is.
And he went.
No one really hated him before. I mean, no.
He went to Miami, and I don't even think you can really fault him for going to Miami. But
I just love the whole
decision.
He can't win without, you know. No, people still fault him with that because that's the whole argument. He can't win without D Wade and Chris Bosh. Even though one of the times he won, Chris Bosh was injured.
Well,
much.
He took him to the finals when D-Wade was not healthy and Chris Bosh was not there. That was against the Pacers.
Yeah, so.
Who were no joke.
Yeah. So that should just make me laugh. If it doesn't matter, I'm not going to sit and argue about LeBron versus Jordan or LeBron versus anybody, really. he's doing an amazing thing this year, and the sad thing is that if they lose and it's looking like it's going that way,
he's going to be 2-4, and that's what people are going to say.
And people are going to say, he choked, he sucks, blah, blah, blah.
He's the greatest loser there ever was.
Yeah. I mean, no other player
could have even gotten him.
And probably even the history of the NBA could have gotten them to where he got them.
And it's not over yet.
No, it's not. I mean, I'm telling you
right now,
beyond all hope that they come back and win.
I am rooting so hard for them to shut the fucking haters up. I am rooting so hard. Mm-hmm. You know something? And it's people that I know really, really well who think that people that are LeBron fans know nothing about basketball. And it really pisses me off. It really does. How can you root against the guy? He's from here. He's from Ohio. He's an Ohio boy. Root for him. I don't get it. Well, it's mostly people here that are fucking hating, too.
No, it's people all over the world. All over the country.
I've never understood, like, and it's same thing with the calls in the NBA Finals. If Michael Jordan was ever getting touched the way LeBron James did, there'd be calls all over the place. He gets hacked every play. Iguodala can't guard him. He hacks him every time. Moving screens that are going on are ridiculous.
Doesn't matter. I just hope the rest of Cleveland shows up because the dude has had no help. So
there's 100 tickets still available. So
yeah, isn't that
really
sad?
Pissed me off.
There's 100 tickets still available for less than $250. We can go to the damn game tonight. Let's go.
Could've. It's not going. I mean, we're not. First of all, we can't make it.
Well, I know. I'm just kidding.
But we could have.
We could have. Right? Yeah. I mean, we could. If we lived, around there.
I promise you this. I will be rooting my motherfucking dick off that they can make it a game 7, because I'm telling you right now, if you give LeBron James a game 7, assholes are going to get real tight in Golden State, and we're going to see what happens.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
King James, motherfucker.
Mm-hmm.
And
done.
Yeah, we're done. So
end of rant.
Anybody who
I want to talk about
Game of Thrones. I'm going to say one thing and one thing only real quick. For those of you who can't stop sucking Michael Jordan's dick, just get back on it and leave us alone. There you go.
Okay.
Anyway, I've just been wanting to say
that
for a while.
They probably say the same thing about you with LeBron James'
dick.
So.
I mean, but I just admitted Michael Jordan was the best player ever. So clearly, I'm not delusional.
Yeah. Anyway, whatever. I'm done. Golden State's probably going to win. By the time we do the next podcast, we'll know. So,
yeah, we'll see. I'm just hoping against hope. Mm-hmm. Go Cavs. Ohio against the world. Fuck you, motherfuckers.
The big thing that happened entertainment wise, Game of fucking Thrones. So, yeah, man, what do you think?
I'm going to save my opinion for the worst part of the show last, and then I'm going to save my opinions on the season until after I talk about the stuff that I thought was good. Arya Stark getting some revenge was cool.
Yep, and now she might be blind.
She is blind. That's what happened in the book. That's what they recreated.
So, yeah.
So, but yes, that was pretty fucking brutal, by the way. Fucking
stabbing
brutal.
Stabbing the dude? Yeah, definitely.
Like, she fucked him up bad. And, you know, I was glad Theon finally, grew his balls back.
Yeah, that was a good moment. That's another thing people seem to be like, what the hell, is Sansa dead? I don't think so.
No. Sansa's fine. Ramsay Bolton is fine.
Yep.
Still. For the love
Stannis?
Of God. Don't know.
We don't really know.
You know, my bet is that he's not dead.
That's what a lot of people keep saying, but
because they kind of cut away. They never cut away in Game of Thrones. They never do. But you never see the blade enter.
Did they show you Ned Stark's head being cut off?
Yes.
Did they really?
So, well, right up to the point that, like, there was no cut, but it was literally, the sword was here, like, Braveheart style.
Yeah.
And then you saw Ned Stark's head on a pike.
You never saw the blade going to his neck in Braveheart.
That's what I said.
No, you didn't, like, even see it close to his neck. I'm saying they started to swing it. They were showing it swing, but, like, they never showed
then,
it. They never showed it anywhere near his head.
And then he lets go of the...
Yeah, thing. But I'm saying they never showed it anywhere near his fucking head. The axe and the head were not in the same shot.
Yes, they were.
No, they weren't.
Okay, we're going to make a bet on this. There's one shot right at the end where it's swinging down and the head is right there looking like this and the axe is there. That's it.
Whatever. I don't care. If you're right, you're right.
All
right.
I'm right. But I'm not going to argue about it.
All right. You're right.
Anyway. Ned Stark's head was on a pike, though.
Remember well, I know he showed that. It to Sansa? Yeah, but that wasn't for like an episode or two later.
It was in the first episode of season. No, this is episode of season 10.
Yeah,
or season 1. It was episode 10 of season 1, the last episode, because that happened in 9.
Yeah, but okay. Well, that's what I'm saying. There could be another episode where his fucking head is laying on the ground. You don't know.
Correct. But they kind of left it, like, Game of Thrones' pattern has always been, we're going to make some major shit happen, and then we're not going to leave that kind of shit hanging for the next season.
I mean, and I don't want to argue about it. I mean, it's, maybe he is alive, I don't know. I'm agreeing with you that we don't know.
Yeah, we just don't know. This is what I'm saying.
Right. What else even happened in the episode? Daenerys is surrounded by Dothraki
yes.
at the end.
And Jorah.
Who I think is going... She's going to somehow get them on her side and they're going to join her army.
Maybe.
That's what I think is going to happen.
Yeah. Jorah Mormont and Dario. I can't remember her last name.
I don't give a
shit. They're going to search for her and they left Grey Worm, Tyrion, and I cannot remember her name.
I don't know. It doesn't matter.
They left them in charge, basically.
Yeah. And what's his name shows back up?
Ah, Varys. Yes. That was cool.
And that's all cool. That'll all be good. Well, but I just... Let's talk about the only thing that really matters that happened in the episode.
Yeah.
And that was... The mutiny. The mutiny, which everybody knew was going to happen anyway. Jon Snow gets stabbed, like 6 or 7 times?
And then in the heart by that punk-ass little bitch, yeah. Ollie.
And is left presumably dead. His eyes are definitely full
of blood.
Open. His blood was spilling out. But the episode ended, so we don't know he's dead.
Okay. Couple things that make me curious, and then my reaction to them.
Okay.
Davos and Melisandre showed up at the ball.
Melisandre's going to resurrect him.
That's what I'm hoping happens.
Well,
there's been theories that maybe he's a warg, like Bran. And that he is going to put his consciousness into Ghost.
Mm-hmm.
That will be retarded.
Mm-hmm.
Or he might reanimate as a White Walker that has full faculty functions. That would also be kind of stupid.
Mm-hmm.
He just needs to be resurrected. The Lord of the Light. She saw Bolton banners burning.
Mm-hmm. I think she set Stannis up. Like, she left him because she realized that he wasn't the right person.
Yeah,
John Snow. And she had taken an interest in Jon Snow and just went back there. And she's going to act like, oh, they were all killed. Like, I didn't do anything wrong. Like, I didn't do it.
Mm-hmm.
I was wrong. I guess I was wrong. Jon Snow, you're the right person.
Yep.
Arise, chicken.
Yeah.
I
just don't think... Could you really give him this heroic moment against a White Walker, the only chance you have?
Then
kill him?
Okay, let me just tell you my whole piece on it.
Good. I want to hear
because this. No, that's one factor, and is he has been so built up, and you just had that huge moment
for
where,
5 years.
His sword can stop White Walker's weapons, and he can kill him, and he had that moment with the Night King where he's staring when they're looking at each other, and no, I don't think you can take that away.
And also, not have that battle between them.
Yeah, and here's my biggest thing about it. Here's the biggest reason why I don't think that he's dead, that he'll come back, is because if you kill him, you completely kill the entire storyline between with the Night's Watch and the White Walkers. Because who the fuck do you care about on the wall besides him? Yeah, Sam's gone, and even if Sam was there.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, Sam's not going to do shit. I mean, yeah, and Sam left too. So who the fuck do you care about? You can't go back to the wall because you don't give a shit about any of those people now.
No, they just killed the best character on the show.
Yeah, so... And of course you don't care about the White Walkers. You almost start fucking rooting for the White Walkers. I mean, you would kill that entire storyline. There's no fucking way they can do that. And I think they know that.
They've killed all their heroes on the show. Here's the contrarians aspect of it, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Game of Thrones DNA says they kill their heroes. And they don't care. Not what time, not when. I mean, they killed Ned Stark in season 1. Nobody's safe, is what they're saying.
I mean, like...
But Jon Snow has been built up this whole time as the hero of the story.
And it's not even...
Not Arya, not Sansa, fuck that. No.
Yeah.
I was talking to Scott, too, and he said, Arya.
Arya's not going to do shit, she's fucking blind now. Anyway, no, I just think that it's not even the fact that he's the hero of the story. I just think that there's no fucking way you can do that. And if they do, they're going to kill the show.
Well,
because what do you have left besides that? Yeah, you have all these side storylines and shit, but you've just killed something that is like building up to be the biggest one of, if not the biggest parts of the show.
The two best episodes of the series are focused on Jon Snow.
Mm-hmm.
Hardhome and The Wall, the battle with the wildlings. Those are the two best episodes, bar none, of the show. It's not even close. Red Wedding
would be third.
Yeah.
Which involved his family.
Right. The Starks. Are you going to keep killing all the Starks? I mean, are you fucking kidding me?
Yeah.
They're all gone. Arya and Sansa. Yep. That's it? That's what you're going to do?
Bran.
Yeah, Bran. Yeah. No. Bran can't even walk. He's going to fight a walker?
People think the Bran might be the hero of the story, too. And take control of one of the dragons.
So he missed an entire season.
Just saying. He could come back and take control of one of the dragons and kill all the motherfuckers up there.
Yeah, we'll see. But there's so many unanswered questions.
Rumors about how Jon Snow will come back if he does. Like the White Walker thing, people are thinking he might take control of the White Walkers and then like actually become their leader. And then somehow when he becomes a White Walker in the book, I guess there's an ice dragon or something underneath Winterfell that's been just sleeping all these years. So that awakens when he becomes a White Walker. And he rides that and takes the White Walkers and battles fucking Daenerys and her dragons and shit. Like, for control of the realm and shit. I don't know. There's all
kinds of... That would be fucking retarded.
There's all kinds of crazy rumors and shit.
They have to bring him back. And Kit Harington said, I'm done.
Yeah, and that's another thing.
You think he's just shining everybody on?
Well, what the fuck's he supposed to say? Hey, you know, it appeared that you just died on that show, cliffhanger, for the next 9 months. Are you really dead? No, I'm not. I'll be back, you know. No. Like, he has to say he's dead.
Winter's coming.
Yeah, he has to say he's dead. It's not even like, that's the stupidest thing I've ever heard. But Kit Harington said no. Well, what's he supposed to do? Say that he's still alive?
Yeah. Well, it's funny because they said he's not contracted for next season, but he's able to be brought back. Yeah, so it didn't make any sense. Of course
he's able to be brought back. Plus, have you seen him lately? He still has that fucking hair and beard.
Yeah, he said he couldn't shave it until the end of the show.
Yeah, well, he was on Jimmy Kimmel, like, right, like, the show was definitely done, like, it was on Friday, Thursday or Friday of last week, they were talking about the final episodes.
Which they'll be shooting again here soon.
Yeah, and he had his fucking hair and his beard, so it's like...
Oh, where they had the three dudes come on and do impersonations of him?
He had...
By the way, that last guy was incredible.
The first guy I thought was better.
Nah, the last guy
was incredible because he could do everything, and he did Jon Snow pretty well, too, but I think the first guy had him, like, dead on.
Nah.
The guy, the American, was the one that sucked the most at
it. Yeah, he was awful.
Yeah.
He was awful.
I mean, yeah, it's better than me, but...
The Canadian, the last guy was a Canadian.
Yeah, he did, like, everybody, though.
Yeah, he did. So that he was did Littlefinger, he did Varys. Mm-hmm. His Littlefinger was good, too.
Yeah, they were all good. His Jon Snow was really good, too, but I just think the first dude was, like... Because even Kit Harington was, like... When he was on, just like...
He's very good.
Damn. I like how they made them all say winter is coming, and then he's like, can I... Winter is coming.
Winter's coming.
And it's like, oh, that killed it. He wins.
Look, there are popular characters on that show. There is no more popular character than Jon Snow.
I mean, I'd still want to watch it only for Daenerys. At this point, if he is killed, the only reason to watch the show are Daenerys and Tyrion.
I will be done. I will not watch it.
That's the only reason to watch it. I'll probably watch
especially it. If he went out like this.
Yeah, and that's another thing. You can't go out like that. Then again, I mean...
All the major dudes that they killed. Look at Robb Stark. Look how he went out.
Look at all the Starks, how they went out. They all kind of go out like bitches.
And they don't deserve it.
Betrayed. I mean, because I guess none of them are expecting it.
No, it's all betrayal.
Ned thinks that he's, you know, going to be fine. And they're like, nope, kill him. What? I mean... And
Arya and Sansa had to watch it.
Yeah.
Rob watches his unborn child.
Sansa watched it, did she?
Yeah, she was there. She had to watch it.
I thought Arya was the only one that saw it.
No, Sansa saw it.
I don't think she did.
I don't know if she saw it or not, but she was on the panel. She might have looked away. I don't know. But Arya.
Well, I know Arya wasn't watching either. She looked away when it actually happened. She's like behind a statue or something. But I didn't think Sansa was actually in the, like, in the fucking.
Oh, I can't. I can't part. Recall. I haven't watched season one in forever. But the.
I mean, Sansa did have to see his head on a fucking spike.
Yeah, on a spike, so. Yes. You're right. You're probably right.
I don't think.
Yeah.
Jon Snow's dead. I think there's. I feel like there's a 0% chance he's dead.
I just feel like, how can you have Ramsay Bolton still alive and Cersei Lannister, by the way, who walked for about 5 minutes that was way too long, butt ass naked?
Didn't feel bad about her at all. So.
Nope.
But I do want her to kill all those motherfuckers because they're even worse.
Yes.
The whole time I was thinking, like, I don't really care, but I do see the wheels.
How about Frankenmountain?
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck that was.
He fucking just woke up and he's like Frankenstein, but he's the mountain. He's definitely the mountain. But I'm 100% with you. I hope she kills everybody.
Yep. Jon Snow's not dead.
No. What about, there was a lot of death. What about Jamie finally having that really nice moment with his daughter? And yep. Then
she died. That was fucked boom. Up. Yeah. I had a feeling, as soon as she kissed her, though, I was like, she's dead. I knew she had that poison
shit on her lips. What a bitch, man. Seriously.
Yep. So that'll be interesting to see what the fuck he does.
Oberyn Martell elected to fight the mountain.
It was his own fault. Yeah. It was all his fault.
What are you so pissed off about?
I don't know. She's a stupid bitch.
I just want the hot lady to come back with Bronn.
Most beautiful woman in the world.
I don't know about that, but she's pretty hot.
Well, that's what they keep calling her.
I'm just glad Bronn made it out alive. That's the only other character I really love.
I love when he was leaving. She's like, tell me one more time, handsome. Who am I? And he's just like, most beautiful woman in the world. He almost killed my ass. And then saved me, so.
Right.
After giving me a show. Anyway, I mean, that's pretty much all I have to say about it. Jon Snow's not dead. Melisandre might fucking resurrect him. He might, I don't know, whatever. He's.
If Jon Snow
ain't dead.
Does not come back.
Ain't dead.
Within that, I will watch abatedly, watch with abated breath, probably that entire season. If he doesn't come back in season 6, I'm going to quit watching that show. Absolutely.
Yeah, there are some rumors too that he'll like warg into a ghost body and then some.
Yeah, that's what I said.
And then come back somehow for season 7 in his own body.
Whatever. I guess I'm gonna have to keep watching it, but I'm pissed. I knew it was coming.
You won't, because he's gonna be resurrecting within the first couple episodes.
You know that, and it's funny because I had mentioned. Because
you know
that.
What, if they don't. No Wall or White Walkers for the whole season. And then everyone's going to be like, what the fuck, man? They were, like, on their way.
Yeah. They may not have that for the entire season. It just depends. You know what?
George R.R. Martin is going to release his damn book before then, probably, in which Jon Snow will be alive. So, because if you heard his comment on it, yeah. Why'd you kill Jon Snow?
He's been pretty definitive. Dead, yeah, he's been
pretty definitive. No, he hasn't been definitive.
No, I mean, like, on all deaths, he goes out of his way to be definitive on it. Whereas on that one, he was playing very coy.
He literally just went like, they're like, why'd you kill him? He's like, really, you think he's dead, do you? I don't know, maybe he is. I'm just kind of like, maybe he is, maybe he isn't.
Don't kill Jon Snow, please.
I mean, he got stabbed a fucking shit ton, so he's definitely...
Right in the heart.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean...
Ollie stabbed him in the heart.
Yeah, maybe he did.
By the way, fuck that kid, seriously.
Yeah, there's another meme online now. I'll never hate anybody as much as, and it's fucking Joffrey. And then, oh, there's this motherfucker, and it's Ramsay, and then it's like, oh, wait, and then it's Stannis, and then they show Ollie at the bottom when it's like, fuck you.
Right. speaking of Stannis, we didn't get to talk about the episode before that. What a piece of shit.
Yeah, I mean, that's why I hope he is dead.
Fuck so him. Do I.
I mean, I wanted to kill Ramsay first, but fuck him.
Yeah.
He got what he deserved.
Killed his fucking daughter, burned her at the stake? Are you fucking kidding me?
Got what he deserved.
Agreed.
Perfect.
Wholeheartedly agreed.
As much as I hate Melisandre, she brings Jon Snow back, I might start liking her.
No, I'm still not gonna like her. I don't care.
I'll like her. I like her a lot more, I know that.
She has nice boobs.
I like her for what she's done.
Yes, but she's also murdered a child.
Yeah, well, but she brought back Jon Snow, so.
That's a really shitty way to look at it.
I mean... for fictional characters, I'll be okay with her.
Yeah.
Jon Snow. Back my, the character I want to see.
Jon Snow, please be okay. Nope, something.
Fine. 0% chance he's dead.
Well, I'm glad you're confident.
Calling it right now.
I'm glad you're not dead. I'll be so upset.
He's not dead.
If he's dead, for real. Seriously.
No, I really don't think he's dead.
I'll be so upset. I'll my bet you think like a set picture will leak sometime? Think somebody will get in? I doubt it.
Nope, probably not. Doesn't matter. We got to wait a long time to find out anyway, so.
We do.
No point in freaking out about it.
Crying over spilt milk, right? Was Siri trying to talk to you?
Sorry, Jake, I didn't get that. Don't tell me that. I got you.
So, anyway, E3, we're going to save that for next week. Mm-hmm. But I did want to mention something really quickly. Did you hear about Xbox One becoming backwards compatible?
Yes, from you.
Ah, what do you think about that?
Cool.
Okay, so there's some details about it. It's basically going to be a virtual Xbox 360 in your Xbox One. Mm. You are going to be able to have your library that you've downloaded definitely available. Any discs, you're going to be able to recognize them and then download them just the way you do now for Xbox One. Mm. However, it's not going to be every game. It's going to be just like it was when Xbox 360 was backwards compatible with Xbox One. There's only going to be certain games at the start. Sorry, yes, Xbox. The original Xbox. There's only going to be certain games that are going to be available. And we'll delve more into this again next week when we have our E3 coverage, which once everything's done, we'll be able to talk about it. It's still going on right now, so there's no sense in necessarily diving right in the middle of it. But there's some cool... Keep an eye out for next week for Black Ops 3 launch... or multiplayer launch trailer. Gears of War 4 was announced. The Ultimate Edition of Gears of War on Xbox One. What else? New controller. PS3 getting exclusivity on DLC for Black Ops 3. There's going to be a whole host of shit. Rainbow Six Vegas, Star Wars Battlefront 2, or Battlefront 3.
PS3?
Yes, PS4, I meant. Has exclusivity on Black Ops 3.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll talk about that later. But the backwards compatibility thing, just don't get your hopes up that every game you own or every obscure game, most of the popular games will be there. Borderlands, Call of Duty, blah, blah, blah.
So they let it, you know, be so you can download like old Nintendo games and shit. I don't really care.
Well, yeah, but it's nice that you don't necessarily have to hang on to your 360.
Oh, well, I mean, sure. But
I get the feeling I've got some games that are not going to be available. Like Marvel Ultimate Alliance and shit like that.
Probably.
So, but anyway, don't get your hopes up too high, but I think so far Microsoft won E3 with that announcement for me. So, we'll see. We'll talk more about that next week. Let's see real quick. My channel. Video manager. So, we're going to check out and see if there's any cool comments, and if there is, we'll shout you out real quick. Oh, definitely. The Fun Runner commented, said, finally a decent commentator that plays World at War on Veteran. Thank you. Appreciate the love. We'll definitely be putting out more to that series. Very much appreciated. We're definitely sorry there's been a long delay on that. I was waiting for this motherfucker to play it with me, but that's probably not going to happen. So let's be honest.
Right. I have no comment. No comment.
And then there was a comment from Dalia Marzarigos or some shit. Just said,
What?
It's just keep talking, just all talking, and then it's so boring. That was on our King Kong versus Godzilla. Go watch the fucking movie. I don't understand. That movie is available in full on...
What? It's just keeps talking?
Right. That movie is available in full on YouTube. So just go watch it.
Yeah, okay. I mean, there's really no point in even commenting on that.
Just go watch it. The guy from Down Under, Italian Job, original. Goodbye Pork Pie, by the way. Don't know what the fuck that is. Dukes, Talking about Dukes of Hazzard, maybe? These would have made it onto my list, but as you said, it's your opinion. Nicely made vid, though. Thank you, the guy from Down Under. I appreciate the fact that you realize that at the beginning of the video, of every top 10 we've ever made, we say, this is our list.
Yeah.
How about some discussion? You actually discussed.
He said that he would have other things on his, but nicely made video.
Yes. Thank you.
Cool beans.
Appreciate that. Anyway, thanks for your comments. Keep commenting. Keep sending us, you know, replies. Subscribe to us on SoundCloud. Subscribe to us on iTunes, YouTube. Check us out on Twitch. There will be some Batman Arkham Knight live streaming going on. Definitely. I may even get Jake to live stream on there.
Batman. What?
I said I may even get you to live stream your gameplay. You know you can do that anytime. Right on your Xbox One. Your internet might be not that great.
Actually, though. You know what? My computer's kind of been shit in the bed lately, so I might have to get that looked at. Mm. I mean, one day it took like 5 hours just to turn on. It was like saying, like, it can't, like, reboot from where it was before. We're trying to get on, like, it hasn't been as bad since then, but,
well,
yeah.
Maybe we'll build you a PC or something.
Okay. So. PC Freddy?
Maybe a new PC Freddy.
Nobody knows what the fuck I'm talking about. Don't worry about it. We'll explain it.
We'll explain it at a later date. We'll explain it
at a later date.
Whenever we get the Super Studio back up and running.
Good luck with that.
Yeah, it's going to be a while.
On that note, I ain't got much else to say, so that was the Super Wheeler Bros podcast for this week. I'm Jake Wheeler.
I'm Mike Wheeler.
Have a super week, motherfucker.
Oh, you took my line.
Yeah. Blocked you from fucking saying it. I get the last word, bitch.